even while we deal with our present problems and difficulties, we cannot lose sight of the future. We cannot afford to be light-hearted. We must continue our efforts. We must find new ways of doing things better than in the past, and we must seek new resources to continue with this performance in the future. This is a task in which your contribution can be a significant one. Para, a brief description on the fourth plan has already been prepared. In a way, this description is essentially an invitation to central ministers, state ministers, private industries, and others to submit or prepare more detailed programs and projects, as well as to work our supporting policy measures so that a draft plan could be prepared and presented to the country for discussion and comment without even a rough preliminary framework. The various agencies responsible for making detailed proposal do not have a reasonable basis for doing so at this stage. Therefore, the number and proposition and targets in the description on the plan should not be looked upon as presenting final or fully considered view and discussion. Much work remains to be done even before a draft of the plan could be submitted. Para, the stress in the fourth plan must be on the well-being of the common man. In the course of the next 10 years or so, it will be our endeavor to ensure minimum living standards to our people. In the realization of this objective, the private sector will necessarily have to play an important role, in as much as the consumer industries, including agriculture, fall almost within the scope of the private sector. The investment anticipated in the private sector as a whole would be more than a third of the total investment in the fourth plan, and the share of the private sector in organized industries is expected to be almost half of the total investment in the industrial field. Such a large investment program present a challenge to provide enterprise which has to press into service all its cleverness to tap investable funds from all possible sources. It would in particular be necessary to make special efforts for enlarging surpluses through cost reduction and increase of efficiency, and to utilize them for reinvestment in the interest of the economy. The government on its part will do all it responsible can to assist private enterprise to fulfill the target assigned to it in the plan. Para, I know that there are many difficulties in the way of setting up new industry. The shortage of foreign exchange has been dogging us at every step. The aid which we receive from friendly countries no doubt make a most valuable contribution. Private investment from abroad in appropriate field, particularly in industries where we are seeking to introduce new techniques, has also to be stimulated, but we must intensify our efforts to increase exports.